Hey guys, good morning and welcome to another episode of Behind the Closed Doors. Now, if you are not into guitars or guitar playing, skip this episode because this is all about guitars. Okay, so what are we gonna do today? Today we are actually doing a sort of upgrade to one of my guitars. Now you might wonder, an upgrade? Frank, tell us more. Well, there we go. Okay, so this is the guitar. It's an Ibanez Prestige 1570. And it's an awesome guitar, but you see something here? Let me explain what this is. Okay, so these things are actually called pickups or pops. So what do pickups do? Well, in essence, when you sing, you have a microphone, right? And that captures vibrations. And a pickup does actually exactly the same thing. You could say it's a microphone that picks up the string vibrations. Now, this is an awesome guitar. I also have a Gem 777 from 1992. It's a Steve Vai signature model, and this one is, well, it's very, very close. The only problem is, when I hear the Steve Vai version, it has a beautiful sound. When I hear this one, it plays great, it holds tune, it's an awesome guitar, but it sounds a little bit plasticky, and that's where something else comes in. Okay, so these are replacement pickups. Let me just lay them down for you guys. It's a UK company called Iron Gear. And I ordered, after their advice, the Steam Hammer for the bridge, Texas Loco for the middle, and a Rolling Mill for the solos in the neck position. Now, normally pickups can be pretty expensive when you go for DiMarcio or, well, Seymour Duncan. Well-known brands, right? So when I was looking for a replacement, I didn't want to spend a lot of money because I have several guitars, but I really liked the way that this one played. So I tried to sell it, and then I didn't sell it because I actually liked how it played, but that sound. So I went online, and a lot of people actually pointed me towards the website from Iron Gear. I ordered the pickups, and in all honesty, they were around 100 euros, including shipment, which is an insane price because normally you pay that for one pickup, probably even more. I didn't want to do it myself, so today we are actually going to Zwolle, to a luthier, and he's gonna actually, well, install the pickups. And after that, I'm gonna show you a comparison between the old pickups and the new ones. So join us to Zwolle, to the luthier, for the installment of these pickups. I'm very, very curious, because in all honesty, for 100 euros, I don't expect a lot, but everybody that wrote a review is over the moon. So I'm actually pretty excited and very, very curious. So let's see what happens. We got time, but no money, but there ain't nobody stopping us. We got bills, but no dollars. But now we don't really give a, no, we don't really give a. Living for that ray of light, life can be beautiful, life can be beautiful. Going all filled up and ready to go. Love an electric car.
no tomorrow. Acting like there's no tomorrow. Acting like this. Acting like this.
Okay, guys, now, of course, you are curious between the difference between the original pickups and the new ones, right? Well, I planned it perfectly. One day, go to the luthier, let him exchange the pickups, and then the next day, record the difference. So, I already recorded the original pickups, the next day, the new pickups would be put in, and then the next day, I would record, well, the comparison. Things didn't go as planned. First of all, there was a little bit of a difference between the original ones and the new ones, so it had to go back to the luthier to change that. And that was the moment, well, when hell broke loose, or in other words, when the whole Corona crisis started. So that meant that for 4 weeks, I had to wait for my guitar because I didn't want to pick it up. But in all honesty, at one point, you just go like, you know what, let's do this safe, put it outside, clean it, and then I will pick it up, and that way we have little to no risk. And remember, in the Netherlands, we are still allowed to travel. Travel in the form of we have to stay at home, of course, but we are allowed to pick something up. So in this case, I picked up my guitar. Now, the difference is, of course, that there's almost a 5 week difference between the original and the new one. And let's be honest, in 5 weeks, it's a home studio. I do change things. So the comparison you're now going to hear sounds different. And well, I can't help that. There's just too much time between those two recordings. And the way that I record, I use a Carvin V3 and I go straight into a Marshall cabinet with two microphones. So it's not like I use direct into a DAW. It's literally recorded by microphones. And over the time, I did change some things. So you will hear a difference between the two guitars. However, listen to the details. And in the end, I will tell you my opinion, but listen to the details, the attack, the different notes, and just listen. Okay, there we go. The comparison between the original pickups and the new ones.
Okay, let's start with the neck position. Try some dirty sounds, and I'm not gonna play a lot, just some chords and a little progression so you can hear the difference. Mostly on the dirty sounds I will only use the bridge, but in this case, and for the solos of course the neck, but in this case we're gonna go through all very quickly. So we'll be right back. That was the bridge. One click up. That was the comparison. I hope you heard a difference. Now, my opinion. The original pickups are okay, but you have to realize that I also have a Jam 777 from 92, and those are the Puff Pros. And in all honesty, when you compare those two, it always felt like the Prestige didn't have enough output, and it was just like there was a blanket over, and whatever I did in my DAW, I could get it sound really nice, but I never had that attack and bite from the Jam. Now, of course, there's a huge price difference between those guitars, let's be honest. Now, what was my original idea? I really liked the way that the Prestige felt. And I didn't want to create a Jam, because I already have a Jam, right? So I decided to go for something completely different. I contacted the guys from Iron Gear, and they actually advised this pickup configuration. My personal opinion, for the money spent, this is an absolute no-brainer. This is just insane. I believe I spent €125, including shipping, for all three pickups. Normally, you buy one high-end pickup for that price, or maybe a little bit less, but you know what I mean, right? You can't get, for €125, you can't re-pick up your whole guitar, if that's a word. So overall, my personal opinion, and I have them in my head, right? It feels the original pickups had a little bit of a blanket over the sound. It felt a little bit plasticky. It's hard to explain, but it didn't feel like strings compared to the Jam. The Jam, when you attack something on the string, you hear every single attack. When you angle your plectrum different, you hear that difference. So that was something that I really missed in the Prestige. It was a great guitar, don't get me wrong, but you just missed that definition. I didn't want to go the Jam way, so I decided to ask Iron Gear, like, hey, what kind of pickups would you advise if I want Metallica in the bridge, but I don't want any active pickups in this guitar, and I want a little bit sweeter, like John Petrucci, Joe Satriani, Steve Vai, a mix of those to throw in a little bit Santana. I want that in the neck. Well, the first reply, of course, is, nah, we wish. But anyway, they gave me this option. And I have to be honest, I'm totally over the moon with the sound. I have several guitars here, and without any doubt, the Iron Gears can, well, you heard it on the video. And that was, by the way, straight from the cabinet. So we didn't do any EQing in the DAW. It was literally two microphones straight into the DAW, render it straight onto a stereo track. So no editing was done, no mastering. It's literally the guitar straight from the microphones. In all honesty, for that kind of money, go out and get some pickups. I know for sure that especially the cheaper guitars, and the Prestige isn't a cheap guitar, so even that one, it was a huge difference. So when you put this in a cheaper Strat or a Squire, man, you will be in absolute bliss by this sound. So I hope you enjoyed this video. Normally, again, this is a 100% photography channel, but during this whole Corona crisis, I decided to also do a little bit of live streams about guitars and this little video on guitars. Well, a little, it actually went a little bit longer. So I hope you enjoyed this. If you like what we do, subscribe to our channel, leave comments below, and of course, smash that like button. But most of all, tell other people about our channel so we can grow. Bye guys, and stay safe. Stay inside as long as possible, or as long as it's not safe outside. So don't risk your life. And, well, we wish you all the best. Bye, guys.